I'm Blake Gex, and this is another nuclear reaction. What's up, survivors? So tonight, at the time of filming, it seems like I'm continuing this recent wave of black metal or black metal-related reactions, because a few days back, I checked out some more Gorlock, and then I did an Azeroth reaction, and you should definitely go back and watch those when you get the chance. But this time around, I'm going to be reacting to a new song by a band suggested to me by my friend Marchin. It's Witchthrone, with their new song and accompanying music video for Failing Consciousness. Now, I've heard some Witchthrone in the past few months, I think, and I've liked what I've heard, but this just came out a week ago, and I can't wait to react to this for the very first time. And of course, fingers crossed that the video doesn't get blocked. I don't think that it will. And of course, afterward, we'll get into the usual lyrical breakdown, which, for those who don't know, for those who are new to the channel, that's really part of what I do here at Nuclear Reactions. In addition to the reaction itself, after that, I get into the meaning of the song, give my own thoughts and perspective. It's a whole immersive experience here. So before we start, I just want to let you guys know that there are two ways to make a request. You can leave a comment, and if I see your request, it goes on the infinite list, and it's a long list, but I will get to your pick eventually, if it's on there. Or, alternatively, you could hop on over to patreon.com/nuclearreactions, join tier 4, the $80 tier, and you can make one request for each month that you're on there, and that gets it bumped up, basically past the list, and reacted to much more quickly. So that tier is there if you want to life hack your way toward getting your request bumped up and done on this channel at a fast pace. Almost as fast pace as I'm talking right now. But maybe not that fast. But I'll do what I can. So yeah, definitely check that out. The link will be in the description below. Also in the description, you'll find the links to the merch store, Yield Nuclear Shop, the second brand new merch store, Death Throat's Clothing, and the Facebook group, The Mushroom Cloud. These are all great ways to share your love and support for the channel and to enhance your experience as a member of the nuclear family. All right, requested by Marchin, fairly recently, actually. And this is a fairly recent release, of course. So I can't wait to check this one out and see what the video is about. Then we'll get into the lyrics afterward. I'm ready for some black metal tonight. So let's jump into this one in 3, 2, 1, go. I've never seen any Witchthrone videos, by the way, before. So, first time for that as well. Yeah, beast to the fucking screen, man. I like that. Gotta turn this one up. Killer vocals on this. Throat bleeding harsh vocals, man. I love them. Okay, initial thoughts. This is just like a fucking, it's like a fucking barrage, a fucking ambuscade of pure aggression and wrath and you know, really, again, throat bleeding is the best way I could put it. I really like the harsh vocals. This is really like a bestial, savage kind of black metal song, at least so far. We're off to an excellent start on this one. Yeah, this is just like a fucking blitzkrieg of harshes and drumming as well. I really like the drumming. The video is interesting so far. Now, the frame that I paused it on, someone's opening like a little bottle, so I'm wondering if somebody's about to get poisoned here. I don't know. Or maybe it's a little potion thing. Is there some ritual work about to happen in this video? I honestly don't know. But so far, the way that it's shot, the aesthetics, the black and white look to everything, the expression on this family's faces, actually, that might be poison. Because I saw those people lying on the floor dead at the beginning of the video. Yeah, my thoughts are all over the place today, guys, so just bear with me. But anyway, aside from that, I feel like the rest of the video, what it's conveying visually so far, is, to me, depression. That's what I'm getting from this. It just shows like a nihilistic kind of depression in this video, and I think that's very interesting, and I'm sure it ties into the lyrics. So we'll get into that after the reaction itself. But anyway, very interesting video so far, and the music is just crazy good. I really, really like this one. So let's continue. Voice of the Kool-Aid kind of shit going down here. I'm trying to pay attention to the video and the music at the same time. It's not easy. This music's so fucking good. Okay, I just gotta say, these vocals are probably some of the best black metal vocals I've heard in a long time. Like, these are just really good. They're going all in, they're holding nothing back, and that's very, very necessary for this kind of black metal. They're absolutely killing it so far. I just love everything about this. The video, once again, is very interesting. I'm not quite sure where it's going, because at first I thought it was like a murder-suicide thing taking place with poisoning all these family members in the video. But now I'm not sure if that's what is actually happening, so I'm trying to, like I said, pay attention to both things at the same time. And that's easier said than done, but I'm doing my best. But yeah, man, fucking Witchthrone. Thank you, Martin, for the suggestion. That's all I can say. Let's finish it up. Interesting, the focus on the crucifix. I'm sure that has some significance or relevance. Listen to that atmosphere right at the end here. Very subtle, very well done. Okay, Witchthrone, failing conscience. Yeah, in the music department, that was just really, really fucking awesome. I mean, the vocals really added a crazy extra element to that song that would not have been there otherwise. Like, the pure savagery of the vocals and just the way that they were done, they sounded so raw and they sounded so animalistic. And, you know, a lot of times when you hear black metal, when you hear the vocals, no matter how well done the harshes are, you still always have the idea in your head that it's just a person at a microphone doing harsh vocals, right? With this one immediately evokes more demonic and more bestial kinds of ideas in your mind as you're listening to it. And that just adds to the song. And I'm sure it adds to where they're going with the message. Of course, we'll get into that afterward. But yeah, I gotta give credit for the vocals because they're so good. And apparently this is off of an upcoming self-titled EP. This is one of four tracks that's going to be on it, along with Circle, Shallow, and Horns. So I'm not sure if I've heard any of those yet, but if not, I've got to check them out when they come out, maybe react to them. But anyway, yeah, the vocals were like the number one thing, and then the drumming, I think, would come in at a close second. And you know what was interesting about this one was that it wasn't like a super fast-paced, wild, all-over-the-place kind of black metal song. Like, it's not something like, you know, what's a good example? any of the really fast and aggressive songs by Marduk, for instance. It wasn't like that. It was aggressive and it was savage and bestial, but in a slower, more methodical kind of way. It was very interesting. Like, the tempo alone, I think, would not have been conducive to the feeling and the energy that the song put out if not for the addition of the vocals. And of course, the drumming helped frame that whole, you know, energy and vibe to the song as well. You can't leave that out, but I really think the vocals really are what make this song special and make this a very interesting band, especially to check out more from in the future. So the music was completely on point. I really, really liked it. I'm very glad that I checked this one out. Yeah, I really like the music. Nothing to complain about, nothing to criticize. The video was very interesting. Again, I really like the aesthetics. I like the black and white style of it. I like the way that it was shot. There was some cool imagery in the video. Again, I find the fixation on the crucifix to be very interesting. Of course, it swung upside down toward the end of the video. But the fact that the woman was, you know, kind of meditating upon it almost in the video itself before she, you know, killed her family and then killed herself, that alone was very interesting. And I'm wondering what the significance of that is. So that is a great transitional point for me to get into the lyrics here. So let's see what we're talking about. Why? A constant question. The voice that is always there. Am I falling down deeper and deeper to the depths of hell? Why would I waste time on something I never had? There is no God above us. The voices are louder. My conscience falls lower. Hellfire take my soul. My own enemy. This constant battle with myself is endless. The pain is always there. My heart bleeds from evil. My mind fully corrupted. My body craves the soil. That's an interesting line. A very dark and very well written line. And these verses repeat, and the battle is endless. I am my enemy. One of the things that immediately jumps out to me about this song is that it's sort of about the rejection of a certain spirituality, which now explains, I think, the cross on the wall and its importance within the video. But also at the same time, being in and of itself an inherently spiritual song. Because not only does the song revolve around the notion that this person is naturally evil and destined to be forever separated from the concepts of God and heaven, but it also revolves entirely around the idea of a conscience, voices in the head, and talks about them as if they're almost their own separate intelligences. And of course, you have that like very Antichrist-looking woman at the end of the video, and you know, the inverted cross. Those two things are very suggestive that I'm kind of on the money in terms of what I'm talking about here. Now, I've got two good Christian friends who would say that everyone is evil, and as a result of that, that's not an automatic disqualifier for getting into heaven. And I don't really agree with that. I mean, I don't even believe in the view of afterlife, you know, that Christians have, nor do I think that everyone naturally has evil in their hearts. But what's interesting to me about this song is that it doesn't seem to be centered around a person who is giving into evil or his idea of hell by choice. It seems like he just sees himself as lost and unsalvageable, and life is pain for him. And more than that, he might be dealing with some sort of psychosis. And that's one thing that the voices in these lyrics could represent. Like it says, the voices are louder, my conscience falls lower. However, the voices could also be darkly spiritual in nature. And look, I feel that it's always necessary to say this, to kind of explain myself for anyone who's new here, to give background to my understanding of songs like this. So I study the occult, I practice rituals, I deliberately attune myself to this world and to dark intelligences. You know, you can call them whatever you like, but that's the term that I often use for them. That's a personal choice that I've made. But as surprising as it may sound for some people, I also agree partially with people who may share my beliefs but be totally opposed to what I'm doing. In other words, people, whether Christian or otherwise, who are against practicing Satanists or occultists because they think it's wrong to evoke or to celebrate or worship demonic spirits. Now, I don't agree that it's wrong, and I don't agree that these intelligences are inherently evil. In fact, I think that these aspects of reality that are partly outside our full perception, I can't speak tonight for some reason, bear with me, I feel like these aspects are above and beyond concepts like good and evil. But I would agree with anyone who might think that interacting with or even focusing heavily on the darkly spiritual can be dangerous. And I've had a few vivid experiences where, even despite the knowledge that I have and the experience that I have, and despite the fact that I voluntarily participate in this, I've had a few vivid experiences in my past where I've had less than ideal circumstances revolving around darkly spiritual incidents. I'll just say it that way. In fact, the last time that happened to me, I was in New Orleans, and that was very surreal, especially the last night I was there. There was some very trippy and very blatantly darkly spiritual encounters and experiences that I had there. And maybe I'll go into detail about that in another video if people really want to hear about it. But I don't think it's necessary to unpack all of that in this video. But yeah, so I'll make an analogy here that I think I made before. And I'll say that fire is certainly dangerous under many circumstances, but that doesn't mean that it isn't an important and fundamental part of reality that has many uses. And that more or less is my view of dark intelligences. There is a chance of getting burned, metaphorically speaking, but that doesn't mean that they're not worth exploring and seeking communion with. Now, and I swear I'm arriving at a point in relation to this song very soon. Sometimes someone completely unsuspecting can have their house set on fire, right? Through no fault of their own. And likewise, sometimes someone completely unsuspecting can be oppressed by the demonic. So that fire that burned down someone's house could be because they came across someone who didn't like them, who happened to be an arsonist, you know? That's one possibility. Or it could have been a freak act of nature, like a lightning strike. And likewise, that person who is being consumed and spiritually afflicted by something dark could be the victim of some curse leveled at them by someone who didn't like them. Or it could be a freak act of the metaphysical. Wrong place, wrong time. Something opened up and things came through and attached themselves to this person. So, you know, if you get the kind of analogy that I'm trying to make here. And the reason I go into all this is because, to my earlier point that being exposed to these spirits is potentially dangerous, I think that a lot of times true nihilism, true emotional pain and depression can be basically caused by something spiritual that doesn't belong. Something in you that you didn't ask for. And again, I keep thinking about that line about voices drowning out the conscience. Now, of course, it could be dealing with a psychological issue, and maybe that's simply what the song is talking about. The reason I jumped immediately to a spirituality-based interpretation of the lyrics is because they seem to purposely raise spiritual questions or ideas. And of course, you have the video and what imagery we saw there as well. Now, the mere fact that the song deals with someone who is clearly bothered by the idea that there's no God above, and the fact that it discusses hellfire and the depths of hell in almost the same breath as it talks about mental voices, makes me think that this is very demonically adjacent writing. And I actually kind of tackled this kind of issue with the recent Gorlock song that I reacted to, where it talked about demonic oppression. And I'll try not to repeat some of what I said there, but I think a lot of the time when someone feels creeping nihilistic thoughts that seem to have been put there by something else, and it's not like nihilism in the philosophical sense, meaning like a meditation on the nature of existence and death, from an almost academically minded standpoint, like sort of like what Mugwa did with their lyrics. When it's not that kind of deliberate, well-formulated, nihilistic outlook, but it's just more of a, why do I feel this way? Why do I feel that nothing matters kind of thing? I think that can often come from outside origins. And there's a certain subsection of theistic Satanism. And for the record, I'm not a theistic Satanist, at least not in the way that you're thinking. But anyway, there's a kind of subsection of that particular branch of Satanism in which people who literally worship a figure called Satan have an almost masochistic outlook, both about themselves and their relationship to Satan. And in those situations, again, in keeping with the inverse of Christianity, something I've talked about heavily in recent reactions, in those cases, it's the opposite of being happy in some idea of paradise and wanting to be loved by the godhead of your religion. So for certain theistic Satanists, they take the opposite view and believe they're basically destined to suffer in hell, and that Satan holds no love for them, but that they have to worship him anyway. And again, I say some, not all theistic Satanists take this approach, because I've also seen more of a belief that they'll be glorified in hell when they die, and, you know, more or less the better to reign in hell than serve in heaven kind of view of things. And, you know, not to beat a dead horse for those who've heard this or know this already, but my view of Satan is that it's a symbol and an archetype representing, among other things, self-empowerment, rebellion against right-hand path religious indoctrination, Epicureanism, self-worship, individualism. So for me, it's a mind, heart, and spirit enriching belief system, rather than something self-destructive or masochistic. But if you take that other view of Satan, ironically, not too far outside of what the Christian faith teaches, then I can see how it can get wrapped up in this self-perception of being evil and condemned to hell. Although, I find it particularly interesting that the person in this song proclaims that there's no God above, but still thinks there's a hell. Unless, of course, the hell in these lyrics is metaphorical, or maybe for this person being nihilistic, the hellfire to them is synonymous with oblivion, a permanent blackout and end to his existence. So no matter which angle you look at this from, I think this is a very interesting way of processing pain and despair and viewing yourself through a darkly spiritual lens. And once again, I think it is very much dealing with a spiritual oppression that's caused by unwanted interference by dark intelligences. Because when it says, the voices are louder, my conscience falls lower, that would imply that he's like sort of delineating a separation between the natural mental voice that is one's conscience and these other invasive voices. You know, there's a clear line drawn there between the two. And, you know, it really could be something more so related to schizophrenia. But that to me only makes sense if you take that one specific verse and isolate it from the rest of the lyrics. But when you read the whole thing and take it all in as one interconnected meditation on depression and existence and a spiritually moral good or evil question, I think the spiritual explanation, as opposed to the psychological one, makes a lot more sense here. So that's my interpretation of what the song is trying to say, you know? And it's also interesting to me, just as a side note, clearly the statement, there is no God above us, in this song, is meant to be a negative one. It's something that this person is not happy about. Or at the very least, this person is embodying people who would not be happy about that possibility. Which is interesting because, you know, if you look at other songs that aren't black metal, that aren't in this realm, that certainly are not in this current headspace that these lyrics seem to be in, like, you know, Imagine by John Lennon being one example, you know, above us only sky, you know. So in that kind of song, in that kind of context, it was meant to be a good, positive thing. But in this one, it seems to be like an oh no, you know, everything is completely fucked, everything is meaningless because there's no God kind of thing. Which I never really understood that, you know. Because to me, the idea that there's no God would be more of an uplifting thing. Because it means that you're in full control of your own life and your destiny. And the outcome to what you do is not predetermined. You have choices to make. You have free will. And I recognize that according to people who believe in the Bible, according to Christians, the free will question and the God question are not mutually exclusive. And there's a way of both of them coexisting simultaneously. And, you know, there's room to have that discussion at a later time if someone wants to. So I'm just acknowledging that. But to me, the free will idea is enhanced and made all the better if there is no God above, you know? So to me, the idea that you're in full control of your life, that you're in full control of your decisions and the consequences that arise from those decisions, not only does it, I think it encourages maturity and taking more responsibility for yourself in your life, but it also takes a certain burden off of you as well. So it's very interesting that in this song, it's written as if it's a bad thing. And it seems to be just part of, a very big part of this person's depression. So, and of course, it might also be meant in correlation to these voices, because if these voices are meant to be demonic in nature, then maybe he is lamenting the fact that he has no idea of God or heaven to contrast them by. You know, in other words, he's seeing it as, this is terrible. All these voices are in my head. All that awaits for me after death is pure oblivion, pure darkness, and there's nothing else. You know, this is all there is. So it's very interesting, man. You know, these are very interesting lyrics and the message behind them, even more so. Now, the way that they're written is not super brilliant or amazing. They're pretty basically written, but the underlying questions and the underlying existential theme that sort of seems to underpin the song here is pretty powerful and warrants some very interesting discussion and some pretty deep thoughts. So, not bad at all, man. The lyrics, I would say, are not as good as the music in terms of how I feel. The music to me was excellent. But yeah, this is like, I gotta add this to some playlist, man. This was very good. So, thank you, Marchin, for the suggestion. That's one less item from the infinite list, and only a million more to go. So, Witchthrone, Failing Conscience. I can't wait to hear more from this band when more songs come out. I'm very excited to check those out. Maybe more are out already, so let me know in the comments. And if you have a request, you can leave it there too. I can put it on the list, or jump on Patreon. It's up to you. But in terms of this song, in terms of rating, I'm going to give this one a very strong 11 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock. It's almost a 12. It's like an 11.9, but you know, I don't deal with all the percentages. I just do 1 through 12, keep it simple. Strong 11 out of 12. And yeah, some pretty dark thoughts here, man. You know, this was a pretty dark headspace. And, you know, I think the key to dealing with nihilism, whether it's approach from a philosophical standpoint or whether it just arises up within you and you don't know why. I think one of the best ways to handle that, as well as handling depression, is to throw yourself into things that are personally creative and constructive. I say this a lot, but you know, diving into artwork, diving into the channel, diving into writing, all of these things are very powerful outlets for dealing with emotional problems, for dealing with depression or any kind of mental or spiritual pain. And it's worked very well for me, and you guys might want to try it as a remedy if you guys are dealing with this. So I'm just throwing that out there. This was a very solid song. Those harsh screams were from like another reality, man. Like, they were insanely good. And yeah, I'm very impressed by this one. Not quite as well, but it's just almost just barely there. It's very, very close. So yeah, there you have it. That's my take on it, my breakdown, my reaction, my opinion. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for subscribing. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so now. All it takes is one click. Costs nothing. Takes 2 seconds. Hit that bell if you want notifications. And plenty more good content to come for you guys. It's on the way. So much love and respect to the nuclear family, and I will catch you all on the next one.